Daddy, can't you see? That guillotine is real. Please take the mark. Daddy, please. Take the mark. Please.
Patty Jo Myers, do you wish to renounce your faith in your God and receive your identification either on your right hand or in your forehead as set forth by Brother Christopher in Article 17A? If so, answer I do, and you will be returned to your rightful place in society.
Revelation chapter 13 verse 16, and he causeth all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. Here is wisdom. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. Be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. The Book of Revelation, chapter 14, verse 9. And the third angel followed them, saying with a loud voice, if any man worship the beast and his image and receive his mark in his forehead or in his hand, the same shall drink of the wine of the wrath of God, which is poured out without mixture into the cup of his indignation, and he shall be tormented with fire and brimstone in the presence of the holy angels and in the presence of the Lamb. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever, and they have no rest day nor night who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever received the mark of his name. Revelation chapter 20 verse 4. And I saw thrones, and they that sat upon them, and judgment was given unto them. And I saw the souls of them that were beheaded for the witness of Yahweh Shai, and for the word of Yahweh, and which had not worshipped the beast, neither his image, neither had received his mark upon their foreheads, or in their hands. And they lived and reigned with the anointed 1,000 years.
Shalom. I want to start off by giving all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakakwadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone who taught me this truth, and salutations to the elect scattered abroad throughout the four corners of the earth. My name is Amon Gabar, back with another lesson, Lord willing, to edify and to feed the lamps of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, through the Holy Spirit, Rakakwadash. All right, now, you know, man, I was just meditating on some things, and it led me to ponder upon the scriptures in 2 Maccabees, the 7th chapter, which I'll get, you know. But before I get it, man, I just want to say that, you know, these Edomites, these elites, you know, right now they're feeling themselves, man. You know, this is the thing that they've longed for such a long time. You know, their new world order, all right, their enterprise. And this right here, the thing that is going on right now, COVID-19 pandemic. You know, this lockdown, this worldwide lockdown, quarantining, you know, North, Central, South America, you know, the eastern parts of this world, you know. This is what Esau had been longing for his, you know, for all this time. And right now, these Edomites are feeling themselves, man. They're feeling themselves, and they really think they're about to do something, you know. They really think they're about to do something. But, you know, I just want to say that this is all they got. This is as far as they can go. You know, this is as far as they can go, man. You know, the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, is only going to allow Esau Edom to get but so far. You know, and this is it. Now, the scriptures say that the devil is going to come down having great wrath because he know that he have a short time, and his time is limited. You know, his time is limited and is very short. All right. This is the book of Job, chapter 14, verse 5. It says, seeing his days are determined, the number of his months are with thee. Thou hast appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. So the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, has an appointed time and date and minute and second and millisecond that these Edomites, these elites, these top bankers, the people that run the world. All right, Job 9 and 24, these guys, the Heavenly Father has a set date and time, a stopwatch on when they would no longer be in power anymore, man. You know? So the Heavenly Father has, his days are determined, his number of his months are with thee. That's why the scriptures say in the book of Revelation 12 and 12, that he's going to come down with great wrath. And I'm going to get that, then I'm going to, Lord willing, go to my original precept. You know, because these are the times we're living in. All right, the year of prophecy 2020, and man, a prophecy just been exploding left and right. And this is one hell of an exciting year. And I'm, you know, we're blessed to see these things that are coming to pass, man. You know, we're blessed to see these things because we're about to witness the kingdom of heaven being ushered in. You know, so this is an honorable thing to partake in this thing, man. It's honorable, you know, and this is not something you take for granted. Meditate on that, man. This is the book of Revelation 12 and 12. Therefore rejoice, ye heavens, and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil. All right, who's the devil? Esau, Edom, these elites, these Rothschilds, these top bankers, these Rockefellers, these DuPonts, all these guys, man. The people that rule the world, the international bankers, that's them. They're the ones that the Heavenly Father, pursuing to Job 9 and 24, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. They run the earth. They run the world. All right? The power is given into their hands as of this rulership. So scriptures say, for the devil has come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he have but a short time. So what does that tell you? That tells you that the elites, they know the prophecies, man. The only way this could be true is if the elites know the prophecies. And how else can they know the prophecies? By the prophets prophesying it, starting with the apostles on down. You know, that's why the scripture said, give him no rest. All right, give him no rest. Now, the less rest you give this devil is the faster he's going to come down with that wrath, because the more you apply that pressure on him is the more he's going to have to react, man. You know, and our defense, our offense, our only move right now is preaching the word of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. That's our tool. That's our weapon. All right, the word of the Lord is sharper than a two-edged sword, man. All right, this is our weapon. This is what we're using to help bring this thing down, man. So you brothers out there, keep pushing. All right, you know, hey man, keep pushing, man. No excuses right now, man. Hardly any of us is, you know, working right now, man. All right, a lot of brothers are laid off. You know, I'm in construction. You know, as of recently this week, they told us, you know, they'll let us know when to come back. And I already know what that means, man. That means now it's time more than ever to spiritually gear up, man. You know. That's fine. That's perfect. That's okay. I'm not even mad, man. You know, it's something called balance. Now is the time to spiritually build yourself up, man. Because if this is it, man, Lord willing, this is it. If this is it, then you're going to need every single time of the day to spiritually prepare yourself for the things that are about to go down, man. All right? So I'll read that one more time. It says, therefore, rejoice ye heavens and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down having great wrath, because he know that he have a short time. All right, as the scriptures say, the Heavenly Father has appointed his bounds that he cannot pass. All right, so let me go to what I was originally pondering on, man. You know, this is the mind state that we got to be in, okay? This is the mind state that we got to be in these latter days, okay? Because, you know, scriptures say the things that are written aforetime are written for our learning. You know, and this is a perfect, you know, example on how we should be in these latter days, man. Ready to give out all for Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, man. All right, listen, man. Let me read this. This is 2 Maccabees 7:1, and Lord willing, I'll try to just read through it real quick, and you know, and just you know, so just bear with me, man. All right, so let's go. This is 2 Maccabees 7:1. It came to pass also that 7 brethren with his mother were taken and compelled by the king against the law to taste swine's flesh, and were tormented with scourges and whips. Okay, now these are Israelites. These are Hebrew Israelites. 7 brothers and a mother. And they were compelled or trying to be forced. Okay, just like how Esau is going to compel us to try to take that chip in that day. This was their hour of temptation. So this is an example that we have to read and to look at for what mindset we should be in when we approach the hour of temptation. Matter of fact, let me get that. All right, let me get that. The book of Revelation, chapter 3, verse 10. Yeah. It says, because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. So the hour of temptation is coming, that's going to test every last single living soul upon this planet earth. But our advantage, man, is that Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai is going to be with us if we keep the word of his patience, man. That means endure unto the end. All right, he that endureth unto the end, the same shall be saved. So once you do this thing, you keep the faith, you keep doing the work until it's a wrap, the Most High said he got us, man. Verse 11, behold, I come quickly, hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take your crown, that no man take thy crown. So what do we have? We have this fire within us, man. This faith, this knowledge, this wisdom, this understanding, our drive and our motivation to push his word and to get the hell up out of Babylon, man. Hold on to that, because we've seen a lot of men lose this during the course of our journey, man. You know? And we know what's going to be the punishment and the repercussions for these guys. And we don't want to be partakers of that. All right. So going back, verse 2. But one of them that spake first said thus, what wouldest thou ask of or learn of us? We are ready to die rather than transgress the laws of our father. So the first one said, listen, we ready to die than to transgress the laws of our father, which is to eat that swine's flesh. And that's the mindset we got to be in. We ready to die than to take a goddamn chip, man. All right, to be tempted under Esau's jurisdiction and power. Verse 3 says, then the king being enraged, commanded pans and cauldrons to be made hot. Man. Verse 4, it says, which forthwith being heated, he commanded to cut out the tongue of him that spake first, and to cut off the utmost parts of his body, and the rest of his brethren and his mother looking on. So they mutilated this guy, man. You know, the uttermost parts of his body, they cut him up, they cut his tongue out. All right, it says, and his siblings and his mother was looking. It says, now when he was thus maimed in all his members, he commended him being yet alive to be brought to the fire. So he was still alive, and they brought him to the pan, the hot pan, and to be fried in the pan. And as the vapors of the pan was for a good space dispersed, they exhorted one another with the mother to die manfully, saying thus, the Lord God Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai looketh upon us, and in truth hath comforted us, as Moses in his song, which witnessed to their face, declaring, saying, and he shall be comforted in his servants. So when the first was dead after this number, they brought the second to make him a mocking stock. And when they had pulled off the skin of his head with the hair, they asked him, will thou eat before thou be punished throughout every member of thy body? So they scalped this man, man. And then they asked him, are you going to eat the swine now? You know, before we punish you and do the same thing we did with your first brother, cut off the members of his body. But he answered in his own language in Hebrew and said, no, la'a. Wherefore he also received the next torment in order as the former did. So he said, no. All right, and he took the torment, he took the torture, okay? And these are our forefathers, man, and this is the mindset that we got to be in these days, man. Ready to die for this truth and ready to die for Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, man, you know? And as I read, the Lord said he's going to keep us from the hour of temptation, and you best believe that the Heavenly Father put the Spirit on these men to withstand these pains and anguish and sufferings for the namesake of Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, and it's going to be the same thing with us. So we don't have nothing to fear, man. All right, we don't have nothing to fear. Verse 9 says, and when he was at the last gasp, he said, thou like a fury takest us out of this present life. Let me read this again. When he was at the last gasp, so his last breath, he said, thou like a fury take us out of this present life. But the king of this world shall raise us up, who have died for his laws unto everlasting life. Now, the Israelites, these men are going to have everlasting life, man. Okay? These men are going to have everlasting life. And that's the same thing that applies to the men of the Lord in these days. Because Yahweh Shai is going to raise up the men that get put to death in these latter days. All right? Now, these men that die for the laws of the Most High, all right, which is a commandment not to take the mark of the beast. All right? And, you know, saying it like that, man, you people that have been mocking and talking about, you know, talking smack about the mark of the beast and saying it's this and that and that and this, what the hell are you going to do in these days, man? Because you're not going to be in the right spirit when that time comes, man. You're not going to be in the right spirit because the time for preparing and building your spirit is now. All right? Verse 10 says, after him was the third made a mocking stock, and when he was required, he put out his tongue and his right and that right soon, holding forth his hands manfully. So he was ready to go out, man. He was like, let's do this. Verse 11, and said courageously, these I had from heaven, for his laws I despised them, and from him I hope to receive them again, in so much as the king and they that were with him marveled at the young man's courage, for that he nothing regarded his pains. So the Heavenly Father put the spirit on him to not feel nothing, man. And I truly believe that, man, that the Heavenly Father could keep you from the hour of temptation. Now, if you think about it, you know, the Heavenly Father could put the spirit on you to not feel pain, man. If you say, Esau, man, let's do this, whatever, I'm believing in my power. The Most High could put the spirit in you to not feel nothing and let you go through that because you proved to him that you're ready to die for him, man. You know? Come on, man. This is our power we're talking about. Just like Daniel, Meshach, Shadrach, and Abednego, when they went into the furnace of fire, they didn't feel no pain. They were in the midst of the fire and they didn't feel no pain. You know? They didn't even, not a single hair on their head were burnt by that fire, man. And they was in that fire. All right. If I'm not mistaken, I believe they said one of the servants went and it got burnt up. If I'm not mistaken, I got to go back and read it. All right. Verse 13 says, now when this man was dead also, they tormented and mangled the fourth in like manner. All right. This is the point, man. This is the point. And this is the part I love, man. This is the part that resonates so deeply with me, man. This says, so when he was ready. All right, this is verse 14. So when he was ready, this is the fourth one. When he was ready to die, he said thus, it is good being put to death by men to look for hope from Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai to be raised up again by him. As for thee, thou shalt have no resurrection to life. And that's why I said, you Edomites, this is it. This is your last chance to rule. That's it. Whatever you do here on out, man, that's it. This is your last chance. But for the Israelites, even the most wickedest Israelites that took hold of your covenant, all right, they're going to die on this side. But in the kingdom of heaven, they're gonna live forever. All right? So what does that say about you damn devils, man? You are nothing but the Most High's whipping stick, the Most High's tool, the hammer of the earth that the Heavenly Father used to cast forth judgment, man. But his chosen people will always be the Israelites. That's all you Edomites are, man. All right? Nothing but a damn tool that's about to be tossed out. All right, let me read this again. So when he was ready to die, he said thus, it is good being put to death by men to look for hope from the Most High to be raised up again by him. So it's good. All right, if we're faced with the pain or the torment or being compelled to get put to death for not worshiping the beast of the image of the beast, man, and taking his mark, then it's a good thing to be put to death by this damn devil. Because we're going to be raised up by Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai. And as for these Edomites, they shall have no resurrection to life, man. Now, let me get another scripture. I might be mixing it up. I think it's 15. Yep. This is 1 Corinthians chapter 15. And I'll start at I'll start at 39. It says, all flesh is not the same flesh, but there is one kind of flesh of men, another flesh of beasts, another of fishes, another of birds. There is also celestial bodies and bodies terrestrial. Celestial meaning heavenly, and terrestrial meaning earthly, from the word terrain, which means from the ground, from the earth. It says, but the glory of the celestial is one, and the glory of the terrestrial is another. It says, there is one glory of the sun, and another glory of the moon, and another glory of the stars, and one differeth from the stars, from another star in glory. So also is the resurrection of the dead. It is sown in corruption, it is raised in corruption. It is sown in dishonor, it is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness, it is sown in power. It is sown a natural body, it is raised a spiritual body. There is a natural body and there's a spiritual body. And it is also written, it is written, that the first Adam was made a living soul, and the last Adam a quickening spirit. Howbeit that not the first which was spiritual, but that which was carnal, which is natural, and afterwards that which is spiritual, which is talking about Yahweh Shai, because Yahweh Shai was the first Adam. He was the first man put on this earth, man. Yahweh Shai is that first man. Alright, he's the first living soul, and then he was the quickening spirit. Okay? Now it says, howbeit that which was not first was spiritual, but that which was natural, and afterwards it was spiritual. When Yahweh Shai was raised from the dead, he became a spiritual body. Right now, Yahweh Shai is in the spirit world with the Heavenly Father sitting at the right hand in the glory. The first man is of the earth, earthy. Second man is of the Lord from heaven. As is there earthy, such are also that are earthy. And as in heavenly, as is the heavenly, such are they that are also heavenly. And as we have borne the image of the earthy, we also shall bear the image of the heavenly. Now I say this, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of the Most High, neither doth corruption inherit corruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. Alright, so in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, just like that, alright, we're going to all be changed. You know, we're going to all be changed once we endure to the end, and we of the elect. Okay, the dead in Yahweh Shai is going to be raised up first, man. Raised up incorruptible. So at that very point, prophecies like the Lord putting the law, statutes, and commandments in our inward parts are going to be fulfilled. Okay, that's going to be fulfilled. Our body's going to be changed. We're going to put off the incorruptible, which meaning not able to sin anymore, go off anymore. So that's going to be the complete fulfillment of the new covenant. The new covenant, when the Lord is going to write the law, statutes, and commandments in our inward parts, man. I believe that's in the book of Jeremiah, 30 and 30. Let me see real quick. Slack you. This is the book of Jeremiah 31 and 31. It says, behold, the days come, saith the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant they break, although I was an husband to them, saith the Lord. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, saith the Lord. I will put my laws in the inward parts and write in their hearts, and they and will be their power, and they shall be my people. So that's the new covenant. And once our bodies are changed, that's what is gonna that's exactly what's gonna happen. It's gonna transpire, and we're gonna be Lord willing, I say we are gonna be made incorruptible. Alright. So going back to 1 Corinthians chapter 15, and I'm gonna end it real soon. It says, flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of the Most High, neither do corruption inherit corruption. Behold, I show you a mystery. We should not all sleep, but we should all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall put on incorruption, if this mortal shall put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying, that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. What is sin? All right, sin is transgression of the law. What is the wages of sin? The wages of sin is death. So the Lord is going to change us, and we're going to put on a new body. The law, statutes, and commandments will be written in our inward parts, and we won't be able to die anymore. That's why the scriptures say death shall be swallowed up in victory. Verse 55, O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to the Most High Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, which giveth us glory, victory through the power of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai, our Lord. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast. This is I'm gonna end here. Therefore, my brethren, you brothers out there, you should say Akum out there pushing this word, be steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. What's the work of the Lord? What we're doing right now. All right, for as much as ye know that the Lord, that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Now, that's something we got to always remember, man. All right, hope is not lost, okay? So don't ever for one moment think that, that you all down and out and you got no hope. No, man, our labor is not in vain. Yahweh Bashem Yahshua will be with us in these days. All right, that's why one of the names that was Emmanuel, the Most High is with us. So the Most High is going to be with us, man. So I hope and pray to Yahweh Bashem Yahshua that this was an edifying lesson to the elect. Till next time, I say Shalom.